Hello, this is Wadiasoft. This video is the first in a multi-part tutorial where I build Redstone Spire's 128 Village Iron Farm. In this video, I create the world, set up the iron ingot and poppy drop area, and build the kill area. Let's go ahead and get started with the tutorial. This is a tutorial for Redstone Spire's iron farm that produces about 5,000 ingots per hour. We're going to go in single player mode, create a new world. I'm going to call it Iron Farm. Redstone Spire WS. We're going to go into creative mode, more world options. Let's put a seed on here. Let's call it Redstone Spire. Leave our structures on, default on. We're going to go cheat, bonus chest, and we got our seed. So let's go ahead and create the world. Come on, world create faster. Now I'm going to look down, see where we are. We are at -27, 62, 176. So this is pretty much spawn, I would imagine. While we're here, let's go ahead and issue some commands. Difficulty, peaceful. I don't want to deal with mobs on this thing. And also there's a new, I think, 1.11 command, a game rule. Do weather cycle. I want to set it to false. I think that'll keep the weather from happening. So now that we've got those out of the way, let's see where we want to build this farm. We're going to have to face north. Well, the farm has to face a certain direction. So it looks like I'll probably build a farm over there. So why don't I right here go ahead and put some command blocks. I want to start with the Teal Lone Wolf sleep bed system. Give Wadiasoft command block. I want to put that down. And we're going to go ahead and set it to always active. Impulse always active. I'm going to paste some text that I got off of a link that I will show you guys later. And it should go ahead and do all its stuff here. And put some stuff on the screen. What that did was allows you to do certain things, such as if I put a bed down here, when I go stand on it, I have options. So that's something that I wanted to have. Another thing I want to do is I want to turn anti-enderman creeping on. I am peaceful, so there shouldn't be any enderman, but I don't want to deal with this. So let's go ahead and do that. All right, I'm going to put the command block down again. This time I am going to set this one to repeat always active. I'm going to paste some code in here. This one came from an Exuma Void on Hermitcraft, so let's go ahead and test that. I'm going to do a little cheating here. Basically this, and I'll put a link for this. This causes the Enderman to spawn with an invisible piston. Where did he go? We lost our Enderman. Well, you know why we lost our Enderman? Because of the mode I'm in. Duh. So that would be game difficulty. Easy. Let's do easy. Okay, let's try that again. Notice how his arm is in front of him. He is holding an empty piston extension. So we are good. Let's go back into peaceful. Again, that I won't need that for here. So basically, I have this Teal Lone Wolf one, which does the sleep bed, and I have the Exuma Void, which does the anti-enderman creeping. So let's go find a location where we are going to actually build this specific one. All right, so let's go for a flight. Let me get rid of my enderman egg. I'll keep my sword, it's not gonna hurt. Again, this is gonna have to face north, so I'm gonna be looking north. It's getting to be a little dark, isn't it? So let's say we're just gonna build it right here. I need to pick a reference place, so why don't I give myself some netherrack, and let's just pillar up. We look like we're a good height. We're a good height. So I'm going to build this thing out of iron blocks. So this is going to be our starting point, -28, 83, 136. So let's, I'm gonna cut here for a moment and put that into my spreadsheet, and I'll print the spreadsheet. That way I'll have all my reference blocks. So just hang on for a second. All right, we have picked our reference block, which is the southwest corner. That is facing north. So I'm gonna turn face the west. Let me set the time. I need to go 5 blocks east-west. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And I also know I need to go 13 blocks to north-south, counting that 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. And then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. Now we're going to the north, and we're going to put the poppy portal. So we're going to put the, give me some obsidian. Now, how do I type here? Whatever. So the poppy portal is just going to hang off the front here. Just a regular looking portal that should go here. Let me check my reference. Back up a little. That's a minus 28. 83, 123, that should be my bottom southwest corner. That is good, and we know we're going to go four across, 2, 3, 4, and then up, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and across, 1, 2, 3, and up. So that top corner should be minus 28, 87, 123. So that is good. Let's light it. I want to see what's in there. Just out of curiosity. Not so bad. Okay. So now that we have that going, let's go ahead and, yeah, let's take the shelf from the back. Let's try not to fall. So basically our chests are gonna fit three from the end, like that. So the chests are going to be in the middle of the floor, like that. And they're going to go back three. It's going to look like this. 1, 2, and I'm going to go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 high. 2, 3, 4, 5. We know the hoppers are going to go in the back. 5. I also know I'm going to stack a wall up from here. It's going to go to the top hopper. It's going to go over the top hopper. I might take some of that off later. I haven't decided. But anyhow, that's going to be a part of our other killing chamber. Packed ice is going to go into the portal on the floor, so I'm actually going to break this block here. Put packed ice there. That's going to come across until we hit the wall where the chest hoppers are. It's going to go to there, and we're going to leave one on the ledge like that. And then we know we're going to put one more here. All right. We also know that we're going to have a, we're going to fall is what we're going to do. I also know I'm going to have a dropper. We're done with the obsidian. Let me check the location of the dropper. So that's going to be 260. That dropper should be facing me, and it should be at minus 26, 84, 130. So that is in a good spot. We know that. Okay. I want to get all this fixed now because it's going to be hard. If we get anything off, it's going to be messed up. I know a hopper's going to go on top of that, like that. We're going to go on the other side and put a block behind it. This will probably all be blocks under here. So behind that one, we're going to put a block. And then we're going to put a downward facing, upward facing dropper. And that's going to be for overflow. And then I know on top of that one, we're going to put a downward, because that's for, this is going to be for iron overflow, and that's going to be for poppy overflow. So we're going to swing back around. I'm going to have a hopper that feeds into that from here, like that. That's going to get fed from below from a filter. So basically this is going to go like that. That's going to go, so basically one above the, so we're going to have a hopper above the dropper. Then this one's going to feed into there. And then we're going to have one above that that feeds into the wall. And that is also a reference. This reference 280, it says poppy filter hopper, and that should be at 27, 180, minus 27, 87, 130. So I know that that's in a good spot. And that's going to end up being my filter. We're going to create one of those cool looking little filters. So what's going to happen is the step's going to fall down here, and it's going to feed into there. I'll show you in a second. Obviously I'm going to have to remove that block. So basically, the iron and the poppies are going to get killed in this thing. They're going to fall into there. I'm going to have a filter on here that's going to filter out. It's going to filter. Actually, this is going to try to turn the corner. But first, it's going to try to drop. There's going to be a filter here that's going to filter poppies. If it's a poppy, it's going to drop it. So it's going to drop into there based on a comparator that I haven't put in there yet. And then if it allows it to drop, it's going to go here, and it's going to try to drop into there and then into there. So if that fills up and that fills up, it's going to go into there. It's going to get burned. Likewise, if it's iron, it's not going to get filtered, so it's going to go there. See, and it's going to go across into there, and then it's going to drop, try to drop into there. And if those all fill up, it's going to go into that one, which is going to burn also. So this is, these two are for handling overflow. Next, we're going to I'm going to make an iron filter. Need an anvil, because I just find it easier to name the items so that they don't, of course, if I put an anvil down, it'd be a little better. 64 sticks. I just like to make sticks and name them filter stick. Oh, I should have left that on there. Whatever. All right, so you know the rule. And then you've, guys, I've probably all seen this standard little item filter. It's going to be a this thing's actually going to feed into two blocks like that, except there's not going to be one here. And then underneath it there's going to be a block in inventory. It'll be easier. So this thing's going to come off like that, okay? And then we're going to put a slab down there, actually, like that. So it's going to be a little T with a slab. It's going to be dust off the back of it. We're also going to need repeaters, and we're going to need a torch. We're missing another comparators, I believe. So off the back of there, we're going to put another block, kill that. This is your standard block, block, block. Put the repeater facing that way. Of course, I should say repeater. With a comparator facing this way. With the torch under that. So now I should be able to get my filters going. What did I do? I need to learn to count. And then if I put my poppies in, they should filter down to 41. That's going to stay facing that wall. Filter down to 41, 1, 20, 23 are in there. Why are 23 in there? Why did I miss here? Because you weren't having me pay attention, guys. Let's try that again. I just want to start this over. I said repeater, not comparator. Oh, crazy stuff. Someone really needs to pay attention to what they're doing. That's a repeater. One tick, delay, regular comparator. Let's try this again. I should be able to put the poppies up here. They'll drop there into there. That'll fill the 41. I believe it'll drop one in there, and it'll pop the rest into there. Let's just confirm that. I think 32, huh? What's it doing? What? Where did my poppies go? This isn't going very good. Why did those go in there? Because someone has a bad filter going, guys. Let's pay attention. I'm just testing everybody. Because I'm sure you know how to take this test. I've built this thing enough times, I should know what I'm doing. The filter's gonna go in facing the wall, right? The filter goes in facing the wall. That should be the filter up there. I have 32, it should be 41. What's going on, guys? That should stay at 41. Why isn't it staying at 41? Maybe it's one of those weird things. Maybe since I dropped it there, some of them went into there instead of falling. That happens if you put things directly in sometimes. It's wishful thinking, but yeah, I was going to say it's because of the way I dropped it. So I thought it was. That's all. That should not be holding 23, though. Let's do the whole thing over again. Let's take our 41. Let's pretend we're just going to go straight down. This is a safer way. Could also go straight down, down, down. That should go. We should try to drop there. We should fill our 41. And we should put one in there. Good. Oh, great. Yeah, that's two. Go in there. Three goes there. Two goes there. Repeater goes there. So we have 33 there. This is just driving me crazy, guys. I've done this enough times. Everything's just disappeared. That went into the chest. There could be a big old cut in here because I screwed this up. Ooh, what did I screw up? We have the torch coming off the front of there. We have that thing with those two guys and that guy with that guy. That guy. Do I have to put a thing there? I don't think I do. That guy goes under there. That guy goes into there. Did I get all my moving parts? Got my filter stick, and I got four of them. Let's just try it again. Let's see what it's doing. So that drops down. That drops set. Oh. I got this thing aiming the wrong way. That's my doing. I'm not used to building it exactly this way. Hopefully this will make a difference. This one. Of course, it's the one with our filter in it, right? The one with the filter in it goes into the wall. This one is actually going across. I don't think I've seen that before. I don't know. That should go that way. So basically, it should drop into there. Just try to keep dropping. Which would drop it into there. Which would drop it down there. So this filtering down, 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 down. There, there. It's going to trap 41 of them in there. The remainder should go down into that dropper. I even have a reference to that map open on another computer. It should not have happened. Okay, so if they feed into here, they should drop there. If they pass the filter, they should drop down there. If they drop there, they should go there. If they go there, they should go there. They should drop there and go into there. I've done it this way before, but it doesn't seem to work. It didn't like it this way, so I'm just going to put the 41 items directly in here. And hopefully it will hold them like that. Hopefully it will hold them. So then if I put 11 items in there, I put 11 items, you saw that. That'll hold one, so 10 should go into there. That filter is overflowing for some reason. What happens if I put an ingot in there? I put some other stuff in there, what will that do? You know what, I am not sure exactly what it's doing. I am not going to worry about that right now. Because in reality, I do remember looking in the finished chest and seeing some poppies in there. So possibly they're not all going in there. I'm not sure, to be honest with you. I'm not going to spend any more time on it. But anyhow, let's keep working on this. Okay, this we're going to have to put a lava burner in here. So I know I can surround that like that. That thing pretty much has glass all around it, as much as it can. Got glass sticking out there. Glass there. Let me see what it has in the front, because this is going to be a pain in the behind to change. You know what, I'm not going to... Let me spin around the other side. I don't... Yeah, it looks like it's got glass all around, like that. Oh, we don't need glass there. So let me see what it has sticking out from that comparator on the other side. Actually, we're on this side with the comparator. I'm swinging around the map. What this thing has in here, it's got glass coming off the hopper and glass coming around the corner from the hopper. So my reference map has glass coming like that and like that, and it's got iron behind it. So that should be good. Now I'm going to do a little cheat thing. I'm not sure how you would do this in creative, in survival, but basically I'm going to do a quick fix because that's going to be cold. All right, I'm going to take these off for now because I would want them on there. So now what we want to happen is anything that goes in there. Actually, we need to set up a timer of sorts. So let's, we got a whole bunch of circuits to make, but let's work on the timer next. The timer shoots, I believe, every 10 seconds or so. It shoots an item into the, well, it shoots whatever in the hopper into the portal. This should have four, which I'm gonna clear out. That's going to have four items. It's going to have four blanks, which I'll blank in a second. I just want to fill the bottom. So basically, coming out the back of the portal, we're going to put one. We're going to fill this bottom with block and that. I'm going to put four holes right here like that. Okay, that's and I may put them. Actually, I probably should have left. Yeah, that's good. Then what I'm going to do is, I think it's an ether hopper timer. I'm pretty sure. Let's get this built up on the end here. I'm going to put a block here. Put my comparator behind it. I don't need lava anymore for now. We're going to put two spaces, and we're going to put another timer. Two spaces. Another comparator. I'm going to put two blocks behind it. Now we're going to take two hoppers facing into each other. I'll fix that in a second. That faces into there. Break that, and that faces into there like that. Those face into each other. Go hold 15 items. And he's got it covered with the building block. Normally I'd put a furnace over it. Then he's got a piece of glowstone. At the end of it. And then we're going to put some sticky pistons with dust behind them. There and there. Put the sticky piston there. Sticky piston there. Or not. Let's take that out for now. Are those too close to each other? Those aren't too close to each other, are they? Yes, they are. The piston's going to hit the comparator end. Let's put a block of redstone in between them. Like that. I'm miscounting here, guys. I should have a piece of dust coming off of the portal. Did my other. So basically, the two sticky pistons are going to cover that hole. So that should go there like that. Well, that's how that works. I did get it right. So about every 10 seconds or so, that should shift a block into the hole. Well, it should shoot whatever's in that dispenser. Let me, do I have, see? Actually, if I were to put stuff in there, let me rephrase that, guys. So at least it's working, okay? It's promising. It's promising. So we're going to need some water streams. So water streams are dangerous around redstone. So let me get some glass protection set up here. This is probably all going to be glass going into that portal. Even the end. And then we're going to put some glass here. Like that. And on the end. And I think I could break this for now because I want to put water. Got to put some water in it. There. And there. And of course, we're out of poppies. So let's load it up a little bit. And then we're going to cover it with glass. Shoots the poppy. Except the very front one, we're going to bring a. We're going to bring. This coming across like that. Okay. And then we're also going to cover that. Maybe we'll open it later, maybe we won't. So let me swing around. Actually, I'm going to put another piece of glowstone. I'm looking at my reference map. It's got, if you're looking at the corner here, it also has a piece of glowstone right there on top of that piston. And it has a piece of dust on it. Like that. Because basically, we have to build a shooter that whenever something goes in here, it shoots. And whenever anything goes in here, it shoots. So we're going to build a set of twins right now. Okay, so these twins are going to be, we have the glowstone coming off the back. That one coming off the back, he is going to have a piece of dust on him, or her. Pretty shouldn't matter. We're going to make it get this right this time. We're going to have a repeater going into that with this behind it. Going, and then behind it is going to go up three, and then across from it, it's going to go across three, and then across the glowstone, we're going to have more stuff. I'm going to put another repeater on here. Ah! And then on the top, we're going to put two more repeaters with dust in between them. And this guy is going to feed into that. And then I'm going to spin around on my reference map to the other side. Actually, let me go behind this glowstone with a piece of dust on it, like this. I'm over my portal. That's going to pop out over there with a piece of dust on it. Like that. Again, I'm on my reference. So then I'm going to make a little cross. So it's going to go three across. Two, three. That's going to go... just going to go down one. And up one. So it does make a little cross. I'm going to put a comparator feeding into there. And... that glowstone is just going to have, looks like more like that. Oh, I got my thing off here, guys. This guy should go two back. See how I move that dust? And then this guy's gonna... I think those guys need to be covered. And I'll put a comparator there. Now if I have this right... whatever's in there should shoot out. Again, that's if I have it right. It's probably because I have to put a block here. So whatever's in there just drops. All right. And then whatever's in there should also drop. Or actually it drops up. So basically, we have built the, I call this the shelf. Here's our reference right here. We have our temporary storage. We have our drop is actually gonna, like I said, the drop is going to drop here. The iron and poppies are going to drop there. They're going to hit here. They're going to try to fall down. They can only fall down if they're a poppy. And then if they're a poppy, they'll fall down. And then the poppies will further try to go into there, but first fall into there. So when that fails and that fails, then they'll go into there. Anything goes in there burns. On the iron side, if it's not a poppy, everything else goes there, which goes into that one, which goes into this one, which turns into that one, which points into that. So it goes here, drops here. If this is full, it goes over there and there. Everything burns. So hopefully I got most of this done. Let me spin around the back. This is one of the tedious parts. It shouldn't be, but it is. So let's call this part done. Let's go work on, I guess, what I'm going to call the kill alley. This is basically going to roughly be a 19x5 box. And we will, this is where these guys are going to drop. So our first area will be a reference, what I call 150. So that's probably going to be right. Going to go up one. 150 is going to be at level 89. Let me see my level 89. Okay. So it's that right there. 28, 89, 131. And I know that's going to go 5 to the east-west. We already have 2, 3, oh, great. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Goes like that. And then we know it's going to go 19, north-south. I already got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19. And that would be on the northwest, and the northwest should be minus 28, 89, 133. This is going to be a nice pretty little box. This could be a nice pretty little box. Well, not a box, but I'm going to go 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and bring it back. Like that. We are now over the chests. The chests are, yeah, we're over the chests. And what we're going to do now is we are going to put more packed ice. I think we're going to put two layers of packed ice on the left with hoppers on the right, I should say, with the hopper chain going back. All right, so now we're going to take our packed ice. On the right side, we are facing north. So basically, we're moving back towards our... That's going to go like that. And we're going to need to drop this into hoppers. The last one is going to drop, right? Okay. So it probably doesn't have to, but we're probably done with the packed ice, at least for a while. That's going to drop down into that. And these are going to not go there. These are going to feed it to here. Like that, and now we're going to make a too high wall with glass everywhere, essentially. So we're going to go 1, 2, 2, 1, 2, glass, 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 glass. Right, now we have this area. We have coming up the back. Now what we need to do is put some... Well, we're going to need to put some water streams, but before we can do that, we're going to put fence gates in. Okay, so basically we're going to put a bunch of fence gates. So let's go ahead first off and... let me get this right because I don't feel like messing this up, guys. All right, let's see. I think... I want to put up three sets of fence gates starting at the portal. They're going to all point forward. So let's figure this out. So we're going to start here. Let's just do some samples here. Maybe I'll cut this before you get to it. I want to use dark oak because I just feel like it. Let me see if I do this. Yeah, if I put them like that, and then I'm going to open them to the front like that. That's what it looks like to me, guys. I just wanted to confirm it. Because that way they're going to face that way. I really don't think it matters which way they face, but that's what we're going to do. So let's fill this. As we know, it can go away. And so now we're going to open all of these. It's only going to get worse, guys, let me tell you. Because now we're going to have to destroy all the nether and put water streams. Like I said, this is the tricky part. I've got to find out where these are not. Got the lines. You see where the lines are? See where the lines are? All the way up. So now when you look down, you should see they're too wide in the middle. That's how you know you have all, that's how you know you have them on all. You see them on the side and they're double in the middle. Now here we got to put water streams, a bunch of water streams pushing this way. So I'm gonna get my bucket, and this is another tricky thing. You don't want to close the gates when you do this. So it's gonna go there. So you should see that all the waters, I'm walking to the south, all the waters should be pushing to the other direction. You see how that's all pushing? See how all the, I'm standing this way, see how the water streams are all going away from me? So just make sure you do that. All right, that's that area. So now what are we going to do? We are going to put a cover on it next.